Welcome students, today we will talk on the topic that is the resources of gene level sequencing. So this all resources for gene level sequencing is a part of the bioinformatics, and it suggests that how the molecular information, whatever is stored in the form of gene or nucleotide or the messenger RNA, can be stored or how we can convert into the databases. So the process of this gene level sequencing is achieved by a number of tools, and that tools are helping to sequencing of the gene. And the first one is, the first tools that we are using for gene level sequencing is Unigene database. Unigene, as the name suggests, uni means single or same kind of gene. So this Unigene database is the database of transcriptome. What the meaning of transcriptome here? This transcriptome is a one of the step or the process which appear during the gene expression. That is transcription to translation process. And these Unigene is made for clustering or assembling of the same type of genes that are from the common ancestry. Second one is the homology. Homology is the staining, or it expresses about the common ancestry relationship. Relation C. So this is the main motto of the homology, which tells about the common ancestry relationship. Third one is the reference sequences. These reference sequences is also a tool. It is a bioinformatic tools as per recommended by the NCBI, and it is the curated database of mRNA and protein. Curated database of mRNA and protein, which is basically used in the human genome project. It is also used in the study of the genome of the rat or the mouses. And this is nowadays, it is reference sequences nowadays is well known, and it is applied or it is useful in designing the molecular chips. It is making the molecular chips that becomes the biochip, or it is also known as gene chips in HGP. So on the arrival of HGP has opened the new door of the bioinformatics, where it is successively used. Now come to the ESTS database, or the tool is called Express Sequence Tags. So while we are doing the process of DNA fingerprinting, or if you want to sequence the gene of the given genome of the chromosome, so there is a term Express Sequence Tags. Expressed Sequence Tags. What is this Express Sequence Tags? Suppose this is the DNA sequence, and it makes the complementary DNA or messenger RNA. So these Express Sequence Tags are the region of the DNA or the region of the messenger RNA which further proceed and which is able to make the protein. So this is it is denoting the functional part of the gene. And this Express Sequence Tags data is in the ribbon-dense. Ribbon-dense means surplus, extra. So how can we manage the ESTS data or that management? So this is converted, or this is done by the Unigene database. I just told that Unigene is similar kind of gene. So whatever the Express databases are there, they are clustered or they are grouped in a single chip, and therefore we can manage the redundancy of the Express Sequence Tags. And these Express Sequence Tags are then taken out. It is making the cluster. After that cluster, it will be converted to the Unigene. That's why it is written the Unigene. And this Unigene is now worked out as a biochip or gene chip. So this is the way. Now while we are going to gene level analysis, there we find the two technical term. Number one is curators and number two is the curation. What the meaning of curators? Curators are the expert and they are responsible for checking out the entry or managing the data, whatever related with the gene level sequencing. So curator is the expert or the person who is handling the data analysis and managing the data, its staging and its proper fitting in the computer. Now come to the what is the curators? Curation. Curation is what? This curation is a process of translation of mRNA gene into the functional protein or functional part. So translation is based on translation rule, and that conversion is known as the curation. So this is the curator versus curator. If we are talking on the different approaches of NCBI to find out the databases and its proper functioning, so let us see that NCBI databases are bioinformatics. Number one, that is the database, name of the database. First database is EMBL, it stands for European Molecular Biology. So EMBL is stand for European Molecular Biology Laboratory, and this is responsible to find out the nucleotide sequences. Whatever the nucleotide sequence in the genome is managed by EMBL, that is European Molecular Biology Laboratory. Now the number two is second database. These are some of the tools or they are the techniques used to assign or to find out the sequencing of the gene. Now Unicode KB is responsible for annotated protein sequences. Sequence annotation is a process that is being done in the DNA fingerprinting or in the human genome project. So annotated protein sequencing. Now PDB, that is the protein database. These protein database is responsible to representing the 3D structure of the protein, 3-dimensional structure of the protein. There are 2-dimensional, 3-dimensional structure of the protein. So PDB stand for protein databases, and it is made for to reduce or to explain the 3-dimensional structure of the protein. Now ribosomal RNA databases, as the name suggests, ribosomal, so it is pertaining to the ribosomal subunit of RNA. So this ribosomal RNA database reveals or describes about the ribosomal RNA subunit sequences. Now the third is the poly database. So these poly database stand for P stand for phylogenetic, A stand for analysis, and this is the alignment of proteins. So this poly database is responsible for the phylogenetic analysis and alignment of the protein. What the meaning of phylogenetics here? Phylogenetic means this is made for the taxonomical study. In what way the organisms are similar or in what way they are dissimilar. So this is the database which provides this information. Apart from that, there is one more that we call the ortholog. So what the meaning of orthology? Ortholog are the gene. These are the gene which are differ. Suppose I'm giving an example, human and chimpanzee, both are from the common ancestry. This is the common ancestry. Now this human is having the gene which is similar to that chimpanzee, so that we call the homolog gene. And ortho means these are the gene which are different. Actually human gene and the chimpanzee gene are having some differences. So whatever the different genes that found in the organism which are from the common ancestry is known as ortholog, or the phenomenon is known as orthology. So this is the method, or this is the some of the tools which are used in the gene level sequencing. Thanks for watching.